Hi, my name is Akshata. Today I am going to discuss about CD-ROM. Agenda for the today discussion would be basics of CD-ROM. Introduction, structure, data storage. Let us move on to the topics one by one. First I am going to explain about introduction to the CD-ROM. CD-ROM stands for a compact disc read-only memory. It is a plastic disc used to store a large amount of data. CD-ROM basically means for a pre-pressed compact disc that contains a data accessible to but not writable by a computer for a data storage and a music playback. CD-ROMs are identical in appearance to audio CDs, and data are stored and retrieved in a very similar manner. A standard 120mm 700MB CD-ROM can actually hold about 737MB of data with the error correction. There are in 1985 yellow backs standard developed by Sony and Philips adapted the format to hold any form of binary data, and there are several formats are used for store a data on a CD-ROM. White book, green book and yellow book, these are the examples. And next we move on to the structure of CD-ROM. Basically, a CD-ROM is a 1.2 mm thick disc of polycarbonate plastic with a thin layer of aluminium reflective metal surface. And a CD-ROM common size would be a 120 mm in a diameter. There may be a small CD-ROM also with a 80 mm diameter also available. Structure of CD-ROM consists of a 4 layers, as we are seeing in the diagram. First, the biggest part consists of a polycarbonate, which is of normally a 1.2 mm, with a thin layer of reflective metal on the top of a polycarbonate. This is made of aluminium. Then a thin layer of protective material on the top of covering reflective metal. The last part is a label or some screen lettering on the top of a protective material. I'm going to explain basically how data storage in CD-ROM take place. Data storage in CD-ROM. Data stored on the CD-ROM disk through the use of pits and landings. As we are seeing in the diagram, pits refers to the trough, the gaps between them referred as a landings. Pits refer to the tiny holes that are burned into the CD using a laser. Landing reflect to unburned portions of the disc. The landings are coated with a reflective medium, and being that there is no alteration in the surface to redirect the laser light. The pits refract the laser light into many different directions, and therefore no direct reflection is seen by the detector. The drive highly focuses laser light to read the data of the CD. The laser directed at the data side of the CD, it penetrates the protective plastic layer, then reaches the reflective surface. The pits and landings reflect the laser differently, as the landings generate a strong reflection back, whereas the pits do not. These two transitions correspond to zeros and ones in a binary number system. The binary signal received by the light from the laser is converted to computer logic and decoded. Now I am going to explain using a 3D animation. Information on a computer is stored as thousands of zeros and ones, called bits. As we are seeing here, this is a compact disc and a laser and a photodiode and a drive motor. On a CD-ROM, bits are represented microscopic thousands of pits and lands. The laser beam focuses on the pits and lands of the disc and is reflected onto the photodiode. The photodiode converts the pulses into an electrical signal that a computer recognizes as a streams of zeros and ones. Thus, we creating a words, images, sounds, etc. Reading a data from a CD. Laser shines on the disc. Pits and lands reflect light differently. Reflected light is picked up by the sensor. Sensor changes light to electrical signal for the computer. Motor moves the head to read all the parts of the spinning CD. I have explained briefly about a CD-ROM. Thanks.